Welcome to Links007 TV News Report, providing you with the best in local and international news updates. This is a place where you can get the most reliable and informative news information. Links007 TV News Report. Welcome and thanks for joining us for Links007 TV News Report. 854 teachers have resigned since January, says the education minister. The Ministry of Education and Youth is reporting that 854 teachers have resigned or tendered their resignation for the period January and September this year. Portfolio Minister Favour Williams made the disclosure during a post-cabinet press briefing at Jamaica House on Wednesday.
We're saying as of yesterday, the number of resignations that we have received, when you look at the period January to September 2023, and remember there are teachers who have resigned effective September. So this is the data that I have standing here this morning, that there are 854 teachers who would have resigned over that period, January to September 2023. Of course, the bulk of that would have been since Friday after they collected their paychecks.
Okay.
But remember, we are comparing like time with like. So
right.
We're comparing January to September 2022 to January to September 2023.
Right. And that number in 2022 was 1,538.
The Minister of Education and Youth, Favour Williams, previously informed on August the 16th that 427 teachers had tenured their resignation for the same period. Some 1,538 teachers resigned over the corresponding period in 2022. Continuing the news, Jamaican man who died at beach in Grand Cayman identified. The Georgetown police have identified the body of a man who died while swimming at a beach in Grand Cayman on Monday. He has been identified as 21-year-old Jamaican Robin Jerome Cameron. His body was identified by a family member. It is reported that Cameron had gone into the sea, swam away from the shore, and then experienced difficulties in the water before he lost consciousness. Members of the public noticed what was happening and fished Cameron out of the water before administering CPR. He was transported to the Cayman Islands Hospital in Georgetown, where he was pronounced dead. He is the eighth person who lost their life in Cayman Island waters this year. Continuing the news, cops hunt for a missing 12-year-old girl. The police are on the hunt for a 12-year-old girl, Akila Sina, otherwise called Rona, a student from South Avenue in Greenwich Town, Kingston 13, who has been reported missing since Tuesday, August 29. According to the Hunts Bay Police, about 9 p.m., Akila was last seen at home dressed in a black blouse, black pants, and a pair of blue slippers. She is of dark complexion, slim built, and about 168 centimeters or 5 feet 6 inches tall. All efforts to locate her have proven futile. Anyone knowing the whereabouts of Akila Sina has been asked to contact the Hunts Bay Police at 876-923-7111, 876-923-6197, the police 119 emergency number, or the nearest police station. Continuing the news, porous police seize illegal firearm and ammunition during spot check. A Clarendon man was arrested following the seizure of a firearm and several rounds of ammunition on the Porous Main Road in Manchester on Wednesday. The Porous Police reported that at around 10 a.m., a team of officers was conducting a vehicle checkpoint in the area when they signaled the driver of a Toyota minibus to stop. He complied, and a male passenger was seen acting in a manner that aroused their suspicion. The suspect was accosted, searched, and one Browning 9mm pistol containing 6 rounds of ammunition was found in his possession. He was later arrested, however his identity is being withheld pending further investigation. Continuing the news, tire repairman shot dead in Spanish Town. The Spanish top police have launched an investigation into the fatal shooting of a tire repairman in the vicinity of March Penn Road on Wednesday night. The deceased has been identified as 40-year-old Dwight Edwards. It is reported that at around 9:10 p.m., residents heard loud explosions and summoned the police. Upon their arrival, lawmen found Edwards' body along a roadway on a bicycle with what appears to be multiple gunshot wounds. He was transferred to the Spanish Town Hospital where he succumbed to his injuries. No motive has yet been established for this latest homicide. Continuing the news. 4 people arrested and $2.5 million recovered in the beryllium robbery that took place in Mandeville, Manchester last week Friday. 4 persons, including a woman, have been arrested and more than $2.5 million recovered in relation to last Friday's brazen robbery at the Scotiabank located on Ward Avenue in Mandeville, Manchester. The disclosure was made by Deputy Commissioner of Police Fitz Bailey, who is in charge of the Crime and Security Portfolio, at a press conference at the Greater Portmore Police Station in St. Catherine on Wednesday. Bailey said that a high-level investigation continues into the robbery, in which a beryllium security team making cash drop-off came under heavy gunfire from criminals. At this time, I can report that we have arrested 4 persons, including a female, and we have recovered so far over $2.5 million, said Bailey.
I know the nation's attention is now focused on the incident that occurred on Friday in Mandeville, the attack on the beryllium workers who went to transport money from Bank of Nova Scotia, and that attack which has caused or caught national attention. I just want to point out that we are conducting a high-level investigation in that matter. And at this time, I can report that we have arrested 4 persons, including a female, and we have recovered so far over 2.5 million Jamaican dollars. The investigation continues as we seek to bring those who are responsible for that act, which I consider is something that is bordering on terrorism. When you can, at that time of the day, without any form of provocation, fire your weapon carelessly, injuring at least 5 people. 2 were seriously injured by that shooting. But we commit, as an organization, the JCF commit ourselves to ensure that this matter is properly investigated and all those persons who are responsible will be brought to justice. I am confident that it will be done.
Mr. Bailey further stated that the Jamaica Constabulary Force, JCF, will properly investigate the matter. We commit to an organization to ensure that this matter is properly investigated and all the persons who are responsible will be brought to justice. I am confident that it will be done, he declared. According to police report, men with high-powered rifles attacked the beryllium security team late on Friday afternoon. The attackers were reportedly challenged, but they managed to make off with 2 bags containing cash that were being delivered to the location. They escaped in a waiting motor car. 5 bystanders were shot and injured and taken to hospital. 2 of the individuals remained admitted in serious condition. Links007 TV will continue to track this story and provide you with the latest information to come on this in a later newscast. Continuing the news. In sports, Sherika Jackson dominated the 200 at the Zurich Diamond League. Jamaica 2-time 200-meter champion Sherika Jackson followed up on her recent win at the 2023 World Athletic Championship in Budapest, Hungary, with a decisive victory in the event at the Zurich Diamond League on Thursday. Jackson was in complete control of the race, leading almost immediately from the start to clock a time of 21.82 seconds. Her winning time was just over 400ths of a second slower than her world lead time she used to claim the World Athletics Championship title on August 25th. The 29-year-old Jamaican has been dominant in the sprint event since Tokyo 2020, where she failed to make it out of the heats. Jackson owns 5 Olympic medals, including gold as a member of the 4x100 relay team. Also in sports, Danielle Williams followed through on her Zurich World Title win. The Jamaican sprint hurdler Danielle Williams secured another victory after winning a gold medal at the World Athletics Championship in Budapest, Hungary on August 24th. She continued her success, beating a strong women's 100-meter hurdles field at the Diamond League meeting in Zurich on Thursday to show her championship win was not a fluke. Williams maintained her lead throughout, crossing the finish line in a time of 12.45 seconds. This achievement came just 1 week after her unexpected victory from the inside lead in the 100-meter hurdles final in Budapest, 8 years after she last claimed victory in Beijing in 2015. This has been Links007 TV News Report. Thanks for watching.